Now we are going to discuss properties part 4 related to RS integration. The statement of the theorem is theorem number 7. If f belongs to R alpha and g belongs to R alpha on closed interval AB, then number A, f into g belongs to R alpha, number B, mod f belongs to R alpha, and mod of integral a to b f d alpha is less than equal to integral a to b mod f d alpha. Proof. We have already proved in theorem number 6 in part 3, properties part 3. We know that if a belongs to R alpha on closed interval a b, m small m less than equal to f less than equal to capital M, phi is continuous on closed interval small m capital M, and h is equal to phi of fx on closed interval a b, then h belongs to R alpha on closed interval a b. It follows from theorem number 6, properties part 3. Suppose this statement as statement number A. Now number A, let f belongs to R alpha on closed interval a b, and let t equal to fx for some x belonging to closed interval a b. If you take phi t equal to t square in a, then for x belonging to closed interval a b, hx which is equal to phi of fx, now it will be phi of t because fx is t, and this will be equal to f square x because we have already taken phi t equal to t square, so it will be f square x, that is h equal to f square, this will belong to R alpha on closed interval a b by previous theorem, that is theorem number 6. That is, if a belongs to R alpha, then f square belongs to R alpha on closed interval a b. Since h belongs to R alpha and g belongs to R alpha on closed interval a b, we have f plus minus g belongs to R alpha. This follows from the properties of Riemann-RS integration. And this will imply f plus minus g square belongs to R alpha on a b by 1, because we have already shown in 1 that if f belongs to R alpha, f square also belongs to R alpha. So if f plus g belongs to R alpha, f plus g square will belong to R alpha, f minus g square will belong to R alpha. From the identity, 4fg equal to f plus g square minus f minus g square, we have f into g equal to 1 by 4 times f plus g square minus f minus g square. Suppose number 2, since f plus g square belongs to R alpha, f minus g square belongs to R alpha, we have f plus g square minus f minus g square belongs to R alpha by 2, because the sum and the difference both will be RS integrable. Also, we also know that if a belongs to R alpha on closed interval a b and c is a scalar, then ch also belongs to R alpha on closed interval a b. So in our case, 1 by 4 times f plus g square minus f minus g square will belong to R alpha, and from 3 it implies that fg belongs to R alpha on closed interval a b. It follows from 3. Now we are going to prove part b of the theorem. If you take phi t equal to mod of t in a statement A, where t equal to fx for some x belonging to closed interval a b, then mod t will be equal to mod f, and as per definition of h, hx is equal to phi of fx, so it will be phi of t, and phi of t is mod of t, so this will be mod of fx. It follows that mod f belongs to R alpha on closed interval a b, as h belongs to R alpha on closed interval a b, because this h has been expressed in terms of phi, where phi is continuous in the closed interval small m capital M. So this is satisfying all the condition of the previous theorem, that is theorem number 6 of properties part 3. So mod f belongs to R alpha on closed interval a b, as h belongs to R alpha on closed interval a b. Now we show that mod of integral a to b f d alpha is less than equal to integral a to b mod f d alpha. We choose c equal to plus minus 1 so that c times integral f d alpha is greater than equal to 0, that is positive. C times integral f d alpha is greater than equal to 0. Then what will happen to mod of integral f d alpha? Here the limits have been dropped. Mod of integral f d alpha will be equal to c times integral f d alpha. If this integral is negative, we shall take c equal to minus 1 to make it positive. And if it is already positive, we shall take c equal to plus 1. So in either case, you can write it equal to c times integral f d alpha. And by property of definite integration, this will be integral c f d alpha. And this will be less than equal to integral mod f d alpha, as this c f is less than, which is equal to f if c equal to 1. And c f is equal to minus f if c equal to minus 1. So in all the cases, CF is less than equal to mod f. Hence we have mod of integral a to b f d alpha is less than equal to integral a to b mod f d alpha.